Hello and welcome back to Manufactio. Since last time I have been tinkering a little bit with the floodlights and I just can't get them to work. For some reason the LV wires just disappear and well, I haven't actually tried an MV wire. Maybe we should do that. Let's just grab a couple of those, see if that will work. Maybe something will blow up. MV wires don't work. So I don't know. I tried moving the transformer from down there up to here and it just keeps blowing up. I have no idea why. So the wires just disappear. It's very strange. So I think I'll hook this one up now to there. And that should bring all these lights back. No. What? Maybe they're not even there, those wires. Never mind. It's just a thing. Apparently they don't quite work as expected. I have done a few things apart from that. I have expanded our range of blast furnaces to 8 because we were getting quite low on resources. So I have been running a little bit back and forth with this, and you can see we have 7,000 copper and 8,000, well, nearly 9,000 iron. But we have nearly filled up one more silo of slag. So I simply don't know what to do with all that slag. When I look in the quest book, was it here? No, yeah, military. We have the concrete. I know concrete uses a lot of slag, but I don't think it uses this much slag. It is one way to gain gunpowder, so we can use it for that. We actually have quite a bit of gunpowder over here, so we're not being shorted on the ammo just yet. I still have some 7 magazines left, so yeah, that'll work. We have been running with the research for most of the time, so we have 9 stacks here and nothing there yet. But it should be working. Yeah, it's filling up ever so slowly. Did I stop the machine? Yeah. So please make some more. We actually do want these things. What? It's out of power. Something is weird here. Why is this one now out of power? Is this one out of power? No. So power is definitely going here. It just doesn't want to go into this machine. Yeah, power is weird. I believe we had everything going, but let's just check over here. Nope, nothing is working. This is going. Did something. Did something disconnect somewhere? Okay, that was just weird. Why did this one suddenly start up again? Everything had power? That was just plain weird. Plain weird. So that was probably the issue why this one was not running, because everything had shut down for no obvious reason. And this one is now running perfectly fine because it has all the power it needs. Yeah, it's just plain weird. Where's the sun? Can't find the sun. Oh. But now we have plenty of red and green research. I have also rearranged our drills a little bit. Let's just jump down here. So I decided to mine this chunk with copper, coal, iron and hard stone. Not really for the hardened stone, but mainly the iron. And of course we can always use the coal. The copper is just nice. Ow, 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 ow. So we moved this one over here and I actually put a breaker switch on it. And the breaker switch is quite funny because when we right click on it... I don't know who gave it that sound effect, but it's rather funny. This one will rather quickly run out of energy when this one is switched off, so it's an easy way to have an on-off switch on these. It just feeds into this belt, and actually I made another one for over here. So this is a pure copper chunk, nearly pure. It has a bit of coal, a bit of lapis, and a heck of a lot of copper. Whenever this one runs out, we had another one, not this chunk, but I think it was this chunk here. Again, heck of a lot of copper. And here, a lot of copper, so I don't think we're going to run out of copper anytime soon. We have maybe 400,000 extra copper lying around there. I might actually just put a burner drill on this one just to get the lapis out and say, okay, it's cleared out. This one's empty and so on. Now, I could incorporate the crusher into this to double our ore, but I think I would need something like 8 or 10 crushers just to keep up with the flow we have here. And as you can see, once this is running, you are getting a lot of resources. 8 blast furnaces is just about enough to keep up, so sometimes I go into this chest and just run over here and throw them through. So they'll just go back into the conveyor line. I could automate it so that it would automatically pick them up and send them across. I don't really care to do that. There is a slight overflow. As you see right now, it's to here. It really depends on how everything is running. See, now it's overflowing into this one. I think that's because we just threw the big stacks in. And there you see there's just a bit of iron coming across. I think that's the last of the stack we threw in. Yeah, 21 iron. So let's just dump that in again. So 8 blast furnaces is just about enough to keep up with 3 electric drills with diamond heads. That's a lot of ore coming in, but we are using quite a lot. I mean, we're not really gaining, not gaining fast anyway, and actually you can see the iron is going down a little bit. So I do actually need more iron coming in, but I expect that as things start backing up in our different factories over here, it should start stopping, to stop the resource consumption. You can see this one is now backing up, so that should stop, ow, death trap. It should stop the usage of gears, and the same on this side, when all the green research is backing up. And it's actually already started, it's nearly completely backed up. Then it'll stop using both the gears and the plates, and again gears and plates. And more plates here. So they will all stop. And we still have a bit of redstone lying there. So that's what's happened since last time. It's a bit of a thing. Today we will be moving on. Last time we unlocked the oil processing. That was here, oil processing. So we're going to make a dowsing rod, which is a rather simple machine, very simple thing to make. A bucket and 2 sticks will give us a dowsing rod. We also need a fluid pump, which is made from fluid components. Fluid pump component, yeah. So I pre-crafted a bunch of those, so we have nearly everything we need. We need 27 of them. There we go. That's 27. The last one will just pop in there. Once we have found some oil, we can pump it out. We need a distillation tower, so I prefab the components we need for distillation tower here. And actually, I think one thing we do want to have is actually this fluid handling. We want the tanks. Is that unlocked on this one? Automation 3 is this one. So we want to unlock this one pretty soon. But let's just run around and check out this. I don't think there's any markers, but we'll just have to rely on not remembering where everything is. I think I want to check this chunk first, because it has nothing. How does it work? Oh, nothing. What about this chunk? Nothing. This chunk. Nothing. Oh, we have to click the ground. If you click the air, nothing happens. If I click the ground, nothing. Aha! Found a large volume of oil, so this is the place. The quest book said that for oil, the fluid pump needs to be placed on a 3x3 of stone, so instead of running around with stone, I suggest I just dig away here. This is actually also a pure iron chunk, so depending on how everything goes, we may actually want to That's not what I want. I do need stone. Then I might actually just put another drill there and just transfer the iron down there. Just so we have everything we want. Do we have any stone? Oh, yes, we do. I think we need six. Six of these. Let's just switch off this. Yep. There, now it'll stick up just a little bit, that's fine. So let's see what happens. What this structure look like. Da 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 da. Here it goes. Oh, that would actually look pretty cool sitting up high, but never mind. It takes 1 million? Holy. That's a lot. I wonder, do we have it? Is the tank actually unlocked for us? No, it's probably not, actually. Where is it? Construction? Tank? Yeah, I don't think it is. So we need a few pipes. And then we need to build a distillation tower. So let's do distillation tower. There we are. Our projector. Craft these. Take these things, and we actually need additional pipes. We have just a few pipes, let's just set it to crafting a few more. I I think this will be fine. So this will be our oil chunk. Where do we want this one to go? There is a thing with the pipe connections, but let's just not care about that. On the sled. Where do we want it? Where do we want it? So this is actually our normal level. Let's just free up this. So we can see a bit more of the machine. Yeah. Now I could actually just have placed all the 3x3 at whatever level I liked. And then had that run. But I think it just looks nicer just having everything on whatever level it is now. So this one is slightly into the ground. We just dig it out like this so it looks a bit more intentional, which of course it is. But I think the distillation tower will go on this end. Yeah, this will be the location of the distillation tower. All I need to figure out is where. There. That'll be how it goes. Don't need this one right now, we need this one. Okay, so fluid pipe there. No, not that one. It takes quite a lot of steel to make this distillation tower. It's a big structure. And there, now we have everything. One thing to note though is that there are a few things that will or will not work. You can actually change the scaffold to be whatever type you want. And sometimes you actually do have to change it. Oh, sun is going down. So we better go and sleep before all the mobs get here. Another thing I actually think we need to set up today is a cobble generator. There is the cobble gen 5000, which should produce a heck of a lot of cobblestone, but for now I've just been using the small mini thing over there. That's been working whenever we need one or two cobblestone. And slabs go around the outside. Now sometimes I've had a few problems with these slabs not being recognized. I don't think it's that big of a deal, and this one is the full size. You see it doesn't recognize these, but I think it normally works with the regular slabs. Otherwise we'll just have to go up and take them down, get the right ones in place. Now this is also a very large structure, so it goes pretty high, but when actually there's a ladder on the side of it, so it's pretty easy to go up and down. And of course the scaffolds here, they are counting as ladders, which is also pretty nice. So it becomes fairly easy to get up and down. So I think we need one level more of these. is how it goes. Because we just have a few more to go. I mean, we are using everything quite fast. And I know I had extra pipes in the inventory because we needed some additional pipes. That should almost be it, because that's the last one of these. Now, I did measure off exact amounts, so it's not like we have a whole lot of things we don't need. So I guess we have one layer more. There we are. So let's just jump down. And we forgot the hammer. So a good whack, and we should be ready to go with the distillation tower. Of course, it may need more than a single whack. So away with those, and those we need. Let's just get the rest of the pipes. There we have them. Okay, let's waggity whack. There we are. So that one goes away. That's the distillation tower. On off switch there. Output. There's the input. That's actually a little bit turned around, but that's okay. This is another output. This one should output bitumen. And as you can see, here's the ladder, so we can go up and we'll go around whatever level we want. We can go straight to the top and actually get a pretty decent view of what's going around. So if we ever get nasty mobs swarming us, this would be a good place to go up. We don't get any creepers and things running up. That's definitely something I would like. I mean, or rather not like to have the creepers coming. But I think we'll go down two levels here. And then go across to here. There. I want... Oh, does it have a specific output? Let's just dig around it and check. Now, does it auto output? Does it need an item? We'll see. Let's hook it up. Just run it. Run it straight. That just makes a little bit more sense. I will probably at some time forget that we have a pipe down here and then wonder where this pipe is going. But okay, now we need power to it. That should be fairly simple. I think we're producing enough power. Let's just get rid of some of the extra things we have. Okay, there. ME wire relay. Did we have? I think we ran out of connectors. That's a pretty simple thing to fix. Let's just make a bunch. There we are. Let's just see how it's going with all this. 33,000. Soon we'll have slag in the last silo. Yeah, I think we are getting closer to emptying a chunk. Iron is going up nicely. I think that's because all the research is backed up. That's good enough. Just grab the connectors we need. Oh, we need the posts. There. Those we want. I wonder, can this one support all the things we want? And especially we want, don't want grass all over the place. Let's see, we will go there. We'll have one that's there. And where is the power input? Oh, it's there. So this one goes on this side. I like that you can use the posts here as ladders. You just walk into them, jump, and up you go. And down you fall when you step off the edge. Nothing new in that. So, connectors, one there, I should actually make a few things more, so that we could have all the things on a switch, but yeah, now it'll just do like this, let's see what happens. Oh, it's pumping oil. Oh, nice. And it's moving. I wonder, do I need something here? This one's full. Let me just figure out how to use this one. So it seems we need a pump to be sitting here in order for this to work. It doesn't auto-eject, and this item is actually so you can tell it what fluid to extract. So if there's multiple fluids in the same chunk, you can specify which one you want. But let's put this one here. We need access to this side. And shift, click, click. That should start that. I can't remember what the bottom is. Whether or not that is actually already set to output. So let's just get rid of that. No, that's an input. There, output. Oh, sorry about that. There we go, and I need the lever. I think I'll just go ahead and make the breakers for the power, because this one, even though it's full, is still consuming 210 RF. That's not that interesting for us. No. Okay, you gotta move. So you will move to this place instead. because we do want to have just one post here. And there we go. It's filling up power again. Once I hit this one, we should start getting oil in here in just a moment. Yeah, I know. Click. Perhaps I should put the output there. Nice and close. And we have. Oh, we need a chest. Quick. Actually, we might want to store the bitumen in a silo, but for now, a chest will do. I think what we'll do is we'll just place a chest now, and then I'll upgrade that to a steel chest. There we go. Bitumen. It is used to make asphalt together with slag, so that would be another use for slag. Although, did I see that right? Yeah, we can use an assembler. So once we get access to the assembler, then this can be done without using 3 iron each time. So we can't really do anything on that. This one is full. Gasoline, diesel and lubricant. I don't know what purpose gasoline has. Normally you can't put it into any of the generators, so I'm not well, what can we use gasoline for? Gasoline. Chemical plant to make plastic sheets from coal and gasoline. What does a chemical plant take? Ooh. Machine controller, sheet, steel sheet, firebox casings, fluid pipes. Yeah, this is actually something we can make, except we don't know how to use make plastic. Let's just have a quick look. What's involved in plastics? 200 of each? Yeah, it's not made in the EFAB, it's made in the chemical plant, so we'll just make a small note of that. Plastic we need for the advanced processes, so let's just see. 1, 2, 3 stacks and a bit. 1, 2, 3 and a bit. That should give us plastic. P24. Let's just dump the rest of the research back in. Not interested in carrying it around. So did that unlock anything else? Let's just have a look. Not here. What's this? Module upgrades. So many modules can be upgraded by replacing or adding specific blocks to the structure using special module blocks. Okay. Productivity. This module gives various modular machine a 4% chance at not consuming ingredients when crafting. Place this block on top of the controller. Oh, that's a nice one. Speed module provides a speed boost to the modular machinery, reducing crafting time by 20% but increasing RF by 20%. The block below the controller is replaced with the speed modular machines as indicated in the blueprint. Okay, I am tempted to go for the productivity. Because, hey, using less ingredients, that's definitely something we want. I have no idea what it is, but let's just get it and... Oh crap. That was not the one I intended. Okay, sun is going down and it's starting to rain. Anyway, we will just unlock both of them. Like this. Pouring rain. Hopefully that'll go away when we sleep. I feel bad about the floodlights. They're normally quite nice, but I don't know what's broken them. They just don't want to work. Now rain, go away. Thank you. Okay, let's just have a quick look at the other pages. Nothing new there. That's because we need this one to be unlocked with the automated workbench. Okay, fair enough. That'll give us access to tanks. This one is for blue research, and that's where we need the plastic thing. Nothing new there. Oh, hello. Chainsaw. What's better than an axe for chopping down trees? Yeah, or the limbs. Yes, a chainsaw. Nah. No, I don't want a chainsaw. Mining drill. If you need to get away from it all and do some manual mining, the mining drill is your new best friend. Now, the immersive engineering mining drill is nice. I think that's this one. Assault rifle? No, we haven't got the military research. I think that let's just look at laboratory upgrades. So productivity module. Can we see that here? Where does it go? No. Productivity. What is it? So what? Is that all? Oh, here we go. Did we just find a sneaky way around it? So any stone and one redstone. We gotta try this. Did we have some additional stone? Yes, we did. 8 of those, please. Go. Can we make 8 productivity modules? That would be sneaky. Or we could use this. Oh, that's a laboratory block. That's fine. There we go. we gotta try it out. Can we place this? No, it doesn't say anything there. But it was also a lab thing. So you can switch off. So, what did it say in the quest book? Automation, productivity. place this block on top of the controller. Okay, so please stop. Missing structure. So that didn't work. Now it's working again. Maybe an advanced laboratory? It says we can. That's the controller block. Yeah, that's a machine controller. So that would be... It seems the lab can't. Okay, so let's look at assembler. Standard assembler. Nope. Advanced assembler. Oh, what's this? Unfamiliar. 824? Didn't I? Oh, that's A. What? So what's... Is that... What's A24? A44? A42. Oh, so we need this one first for whatever that thing was that we need underneath that. So if I can't put it there, can I just plop it on top of this? I think I'll just plop them. Where did that one go? Oh, it's already there. Well, I wonder if that's how you're supposed to do it. But the instruction did say on top of the machine controller. And that's there. And it is named MM Productivity Module. Yep. Let's just get all of them. Okay, that one doesn't like it. Ah, it'll just get power from the other side. That's okay. We have sufficient death traps over here already. So I think that's all the assemblers that now have this. No idea if it'll make any difference, but okay. Yeah, almost full on slack. Let's just see how much overflow we have here. Yeah, we have a bit. What I sometimes do is I just take any overflow and stuff it in here, and then this blast furnace will just process it. I just need to manually remove the slack and dump it over here. I haven't seen this one actually being able to overflow yet with too much. So even though we have a heck of a lot of resources coming in here, this one is just taking them and passing them along without any delay whatsoever. That's pretty nice. Anyway, what did we want? We looked at this automation that requires automation 3, which was this one. I think I do want to set up a few tanks. So we have a tank for each of the three fluids we had down in the distillation tower. For that we need 100 of each. So we're nearly clearing the backlog now. So this is the automated workbench structure. The factory requires a lot of specific components, and an automated workbench will craft these products automatically and in many cases more efficient on resource usage. Provides the automated workbench structure. Yeah. That I like. Automation 3. There. Okay, that unlocked automation 4. What's this? That is the assembler. Ooh, that's both blue and then purple research. Okay, that assembler is not coming anytime. Is it already night again? It is. We're not getting the assembler anytime soon, but tanks is 100 red. That's the multi-block storage tank, yes, and a portable tank, and yep, bottling machine and basic mechanical pipe. Ooh, that's good. The mechanical pipe is a nifty thing from mechanism, and let's just see if we can get the configurator as well. If we can, then we don't really need many of the fluid pumps we have around. That the pipes can just do it internally. But it does need a configurator, otherwise it won't really do all that much. So what is involved in the basic mechanical pipe? That's this one. It can pump 100 mil buckets per tick, steel plates and fluid pipe for 2. That's okay, that's okay. Oh, no, it's just basic assembler. That's the only way, yeah. So, that's fine. I can do that. And later when we get this advanced alloy, we can upgrade it. That should give it quite a lot more. But the question is, do we have the configurator? Can we make this one? Iron rod, and basic control. Circuit, we most certainly can. Now I'm tempted to change it, but nah, not yet. First though, we need some tank things, so I'll be doing that. And there we are. Now we have 3 sets of tanks. They are built exactly like the silo, it's just one layer less. So that's pretty easy to do. And I might have gone a little bit overboard on the sheet metal, but hey, we are most likely going to need it. I also crafted some new pipes. I know the distillation tower will auto output, so we just need to route it around here. And actually we do need these pipes. They will go on top. So it needs to go up like this, and I just need, a way up. Let's go up this way. I think we can do it here. There we are. And we'll just feed it in this way. There. Now, can I break that connection? I totally can. I also want that connection broken. Now the question is, do we have something in that pipe already? If we do, we don't particularly want it. So let's just see if we can empty it out. No, still empty. Still, it's empty. I just needed to be sure, because if we got just a partial amount into one of these tanks, it's you have to break it and redo it. So that's a bit annoying. Ouch. There, now it's auto-putting gasoline. And this one should become a gasoline tank quite soon. So if I right click it, nothing happens. Okay, now it's dumped all the gasoline in. And this one has a fluid. Is it? How do I see? Oh crap. It has all of them. Okay, we will. Now it's actually outputting diesel, so good thing we have this one. And I think we need a lever and a bit of sleep. Sleep is the most important. And I totally forgot that it will input evenly across all inventories. Now we could of course just break all the things, but I don't know, I want to conserve resources on the gasoline part. So let's see if we can do this. Yep, now it has gasoline in it. A lot. Okay. Can I click? No, I can't. Okay, now that has. Maybe I can. Ah, I can! Hey, so it's emptying gasoline. That's good. This one is also emptying gasoline. Very good. Now this one is empty. We can take all this out. Ah, give me my lever. I need it. Thank you. Take this down and repeat the process on the next one. So this should be diesel. Normally when you click on it, it'll tell you how much you have. That's a bit annoying. I just want to be sure. Now it's lubricant. I'll just wait until this one is finished, because it is creating all the things, and those are in the pipes right now. Actually, this one is. Oh, it is working. It is working. But we can set up this thing. So we can get the gasoline out whenever this one is full. I think we'll just pump it. Never mind. Hopefully we'll get some good things out. Can I? Nope, I can't. Use pipes as scaffold. Never mind. I want to break this one. Then we are sure we're not getting gasoline back. Empty out. This one will fill up. Diesel is good. Lubricant is good. Now, lubricant you can use for a lot of different purposes. You can lubricate the diesel engines, you can lubricate on, there it is, the crusher, and those things with the automated lubricant. However, I think that's a different quest, or yeah, that's automatic lubrication, where we can make them run faster. So that might actually be what we need on the crusher to keep up, but we'll have to test it out. This one is almost full of lubricant. Yeah, we're getting a lot of gasoline and diesel. I wonder which one we're going to use. Oh, there's an Enderman somewhere. Actually, an Enderman could be a problem because we can shoot him, but I think he will ignore projectiles and just teleport away. That might be an issue for us. Okay, this one is done. And oh yeah, if you break these tank structures, everything goes away. So if you happen to do it by mistake, you're just screwed. You won't get any of it back. Lubricant is almost backing up. I'd really want to wait until we only have lubricant. Or maybe we can poke a hole here and dump this one in and see what we have. Lubricant, that is what we want. Oh. And I still need a way up. Ah, oh, this is a strange staircase, but I suppose it'll have to do. This auto outputs to the bottom, and it doesn't connect the pipe. We could feed it through there. I don't want to do that. So now this one is locked in as a lubricant receiver. So that should drain the distillation tower completely. Yeah, look at that. So, outputting lubricant. Now it's putting gasoline in. And diesel. It's only outputting one resource at a time. The others will just back up in this chamber. So, this one could actually keep up with one or two more of these with no problems. But I think at the rate with which we are filling up these tanks, it won't be long before everything backs up. Let's just have a quick look over here. We are producing bitumen at a fast rate. Coal. This one is keeping up. There's just the excess materials from that chunk. They can just go here. So I think that is it for today. We got the fluid pump, we got the distillation tower, and basically we got the oil resources. Now those we need for plastic production, so I'll see you next time. Bye bye.